Positive feedback moves in a loop like a chicken chilling in a coop, and the egg it's bound to produce. When the egg hatches, it's gonna be a chicken too, and then that chicken's gonna lay an egg, and then the whole process repeats. And we ask ourselves rhetorically, which one came first? Knowing that it really makes no difference, because as long as there's a chicken, there will be an egg, and vice versa. Similarly, water vapor makes it warmer, and the warmer it gets, the more the air gets wet, because the vapor, it thrives as the temperatures rise. But you see, this increase in degrees is caused by the vapor itself, as it is indeed a rather potent gas of a house that's green. So it's like a cycle, you see what I mean? And then the ice melts, leaving less of a surface to reflect the heat away, causing more ice to melt. Like, what the hell? Can't we catch a break here? Come on, mate. Surely it ain't too late. But then the clouds, now this one's a little bit different, because it kind of goes both ways here. The clouds hang low, then the cool winds blow. But if they soar up high in the sky, well, then it's bound to be a bit of a scorcher, my guy. It's negative. It's positive. But I'll tell you what it ain't, neutral. And neither should you be, don't you see? Or are you too busy skipping to the same old beat as everybody else? Go ahead. Go ahead.
Smoke from a source so primitive fills the air in quantities unlimited. But we just drive on by, wishing not to veer from our lane, the fast lane, on the highway to our certain demise. It's going down. Lord knows it's going down.
The global carbon cycle, once virtuous, now quite vicious. Though our intentions may not have been malicious, the result has been far from nutritious for the health of our cherished biosphere. So soon we shall perish, the time is near. The time to fear has come, but it passed long ago. For now we have come to the end of our show. And so we'd like to thank the ocean for its loving devotion to keeping the curtain from dropping for certain by capturing some of that carbon release and tucking it into its transparent fleece. Mr. Plank, thanks a ton. Mr. Al, golly gee. With all of your help, we've managed to keep our atmosphere free of nearly half the CO2 that would otherwise be floating all around it like rabid jellyfish waiting to sting us all at once.